Regulates our respiration at the time of our birth and continues to vibrate as long as we are permitted to respire. The moment the Om is withdrawn into the space where you live, then your lungs stop. Even in the presence of expert cardiologists and pulmonary experts, even though the lungs are mechanically made to work once again, they do not function at all, because the sacred word is reabsorbed into its birthplace. This is one of the stories of the symbolism of the Saraswati. Now let us say hello to the other two fellows also. They are waiting for us. I told you yesterday that Vishnu is having a blue-colored body. That means the content of the space is his body. And he has his wife, who is very sweet to him. She is called Lakshmi. She is also called the goddess of splendor and wealth. Here, wealth does not mean gold or packets of currency or bank books. Wealth means the wealth of the creation. The wealth of the creation exists in existence or span. Wealth of the creation is in its span. Wealth of the creation is in its existence. Otherwise, if this fellow is producing and if this fellow is destroying, there will be a continuous birth and instantaneous death of beings and worlds. Yes, I'll repeat. I think there is some loose contact somewhere. Yes. Some little trouble with the contact. Some plug is not properly contacted. Must be, or some wire is. You can remove the stereos. No discussion. Better remove the stereos. Everything will be okay. If there is discussion, there is more noise. Okay. Oh, he is also Michelle. Then it will be good. What happens when this fellow is busily creating and immediately this fellow is destroying? It will be an abortion of creation. No existence. So what for world is created? It is for a new fellow who is called the guest. It is to invite the guest that the world is described, that the world is created. That is how it is described in the scriptures. Who is the guest? He is considered to be a foreigner to creation. That is, for an Indian to invite a Belgian, or for Belgians to invite an Indian, the creation is like that, to invite a foreign guest. Just I will explain you what it is. If you take three different items, the sugar, milk and coffee, black coffee, they are three items. When you mix up, it is not any one of the three items. It is a fourth item. Like that, when the components of the creation are mixed up, when the seven planes of existence are compounded properly, in the technological laboratory of the four chambers, That is the Brahma's faces, the four stages of utterance. Then there will be the eighth fellow coming into existence. That is called the birth of the individual. Previously he was not there. And even when you count the items in the combination, there are only seven, but the whole combination makes a manifestation of eighth fellow, who is called the guest. If anyone asks you who you are, you can't say that you are one of the components of your body or mind. You are yourself, and you exist as long as the combination exists. Once the combination is taken away, the guest disappears. He has a takeoff to his native land by a beautiful aeroplane called disappearance. That is how it is described in the scriptures. I will give you also another example. Five people started in a little aeroplane from Liège to the United States of America. To cross the ocean, there are many, many hours of duration. In the meanwhile, what to do? So, they are experts in playing cards. So, they took out the higher bridge from the lower bridge. That is, from the cassette of the playing cards, they took out the beautiful packet of the playing cards. They wanted to play a game. So there were only five. But when they began to distribute, they found six. And they had to distribute the cards to six people. And for about 13 or 14 hours, as long as the journey was taking place, six people played the game. And when everything was finished, they got up from the plane and discussed how the game took place among six people. Because when they got up once again, there were only five. You can imagine such a story. This is what happens in creation. The number of components made up into an individual will have x plus one number. That one being the guest, who is called the individual. He is a temporary existence who is depending upon the Vishnu principle. That is the equilibrium of all the other forces. That is why this lady of Vishnu is said to invite the guest. For that reason, she is the goddess of riches and splendors. That is how it is described. And the word Lakshmi indicates symbol. Exactly, the word Lakshmi means symbol. What is it? If I meet you in the street and say, "Hello, Marcel," how could I recognize that you are Marcel? It is because of your face, nose, body, etc. But do you accept if I say your face is Marcel? Certainly not. If I say your skirt is Marcel, our body is Marcel, or that nose is Marcel, or those two humorous eyes are Marcel, will never admit. They are symbols which are intended to make me know that you are Marcel. That is how she forms the symbol of everything in this universe. If I say you are Marcel, you may say yes, but you are absent-minded. Because Marcel is only a word and not the person. So it is another symbol. So it is also among the wealth of Lakshmi. If I listen to your voice from the other side of the wall, if you are talking to another friend and say, I say, here is Marcel. Does that mean your voice is Marcel? Not at all. But it is also another symbol. Like this, this goddess of splendors and wealth produces millions and millions of symbols through which the same fellow plays, looks to himself in the form of the millions of persons. Because now he has many mirrors with him, two mirrors opposite to each other, and the fellow is standing between the two mirrors. He can have any number of images. So he likes to play like that. The one I am of existence, existing through the many wheels of symbols. He calls himself in the form of two persons. One person says, hello Marcel. Another person says, hello Master. But the same person in two bottles, two sets of symbols. One group of symbols is the face of Marcel, the eyebrows of Marcel, etc. Another group of symbol is the skirt of Marcel, the pant of Marcel, etc. Another group is your voice and tush. So you have many hundreds of groups of symbols to make me know that you are Marcel. But the only one fellow is talking to himself in the many thousands of forms. That is what is called Vishnu playing in the splendor of Lakshmi. That is how it is described. For this reason, she is called Lakshmi, or the lady of symbol. And he is always playing, and his play is to exist as the many thousand little beings. And each little being is trying to understand the other as a different one. And in that lies his pleasure. Because you know how the boy plays. And for hours and hours, he will be playing his own game. If you call him and ask, why do you play? He says, I play. The same answer we get from God also. Once again, if you call the boy and say, no, tell me the reason why you play. What is the answer? He says, he. The same answer we receive from God. If we question God, why this creation? With the face of a philosopher, we many times question him. Why all this creation? What for he has created? He says, he. Because he is a boy, always playing. It is a game. He has no answer. Because yours is not a question. When you question the boy, why do you play? To you, an elderly brain, it may be a question. But to him, the fresh brain, it is no question at all. To him, it is nonsense. So goes the creation between Vishnu and Lakshmi. And Vishnu has two phases of his existence. The passive phase and the active phase. Because the space unbound has passive and active spaces alternating. And space unbound is his body blue colored. So he has two stages of existence. In one stage he is passive. Say he is sleeping. In fact, it is not sleep. because sleep is the quality of mind and not the quality of space. We can compare it with what we have. Therefore, the scriptures compare it to his sleep. They call this conscious sleep. And they describe he sleeps because he wants to sleep. See, he is a mischievous fellow. When he wants to sleep, that means he is not sleeping. In our sleep, you cannot want to sleep. You don't know because you are sleeping. But he sleeps. And he knows that he is sleeping. It is false sleep or the boy playing the game of sleep. And while sleeping, he will stretch his body on the coiled serpent. And the serpent floats upon the ocean, having no shores. The serpent represents eternity, and its name is also eternity. In Sanskrit, it is called Ananta. It means eternity. The name of that serpent is eternity. It exists in a coiled condition or a potential state. And the ocean is called the background consciousness, the content of space. And his wife, you know where she will be? Do you think that she will be in his bed? No, he is on his chest. You will find his wife described on his chest. That means when the whole creation goes into the passive state, whole creation means one unit creation. When it goes into the passive state, which we call dissolution, because we will not be there. Just as in our sleep we are not there, in the passive state we are not there. Therefore we call it destruction or dissolution. In that state, all the symbols go and they take their seat in his heart, which exists everywhere in space, with its center everywhere and circumference nowhere. So she is in his heart. And once again, when the time comes for the active phase to alternate, she makes the first manifestation in the form of his fancy to create. He thinks, he recollects, how is it if I play in the form of thousands of living beings? That is how he begins to feel it at heart. So in the form of that feeling, she comes out from the heart. In the meanwhile, she sleeps in the heart. That is why in the pictures you will find Lakshmi sitting on his chest. This is one aspect of Vishnu's symbolism. And then he immediately gets up. He takes his wash. And he'll have his dress. And then he sits upon his vehicle. Do you know what is his vehicle? It is called the Grand Eagle. And he comes down to earth on the wings of the Grand Eagle. What does that mean? The Grand Eagle signifies the respiration of the creation. And immediately the lotus comes from his navel. And the creator four-faced comes out of the lotus. And he begins to utter the four words into the form of creation. Then on the seventh lowest stage of these four worlds, which we call the physical existence, there will be the living beings in physical bodies, and into their lungs the Lord enters on the eagle and exists in the form of Om. Then the bird is moving its wings, which is we call our respirations. This is a part of the symbolism of Vishnu. And thank you for today. Yesterday I promised to discuss a question, but conveniently enough I forgot about it. And tomorrow, so tomorrow you please remind me in the beginning of the lecture, because I have a very bad memory. No, I want some air.
Of the four elements.
I thank the host of the evening who has created such a pleasant gathering here, and I try to go into the time of the evening when I spoke of the six darshanas previously, because my host Madam Yama Brahe finds it showering with energy. That is what she says on that evening. The showering of energy always depends upon those who attend, not those who speak. Just as the appreciation of a lecture does not depend upon the microphone used, it depends upon the audience and their heart, about which I have every hope. So this evening also, I feel Yama Brahe will have the same showering of energy. And our today's topic is about the six darshanas. In Sanskrit, the word darshana means a vision. There are six different angles of vision to look at the same book. The book is called the Book of Creation, which is periodical every day and minute, changing every second. But at the same time, the periodicity is permanent. The succession and the modes of change is permanent. And therefore, the whole thing is eternal. Along with all the changes that take place, the setup is eternal. That's the reason why the creation is said to be eternally periodical. It is the mystic language of the authors of the scriptures to call the creation the book, whereas all the other books we call a book. The difference is the book of creation is unchanged, with all the pages full of changes. Every page of creation is full of many changes, big and small. But if you begin to study the whole volume, you can read the same story again and again. And therefore, you can call it the Book of Change and the Book of Eternity. This is called a book by the authors of the scriptures, because it contains all the wisdom of creation in itself. That is, the physical body of the Creator and the existence of the Creator and the activity of the Creator, all put together form the story of the book. So the book includes all the three. Therefore, it is called the book, the impersonal book. That is the meaning of what we say, the Bible. And in Sanskrit, it is called Veda. Veda means the book of wisdom, which is impersonal. It is described that no one has composed this book, though everyone can copy some portion of this book in the form of his own books. This is the basis of all wisdom according to the Indian scriptures.
Telle est la base de toute sagesse.
And whoever writes anything spiritually, explains or formulates, he is expected to do it to explain the book of creation and explain something of its law and bylaw and the application of the law and how the beings come into existence, and it is called cosmology, and how the individuals each come into existence, which is called embryology, and how man comes into existence, it's called anthropogenesis, and how man finds this whole universe, that is called the mystery of objectivity. These are the chapters that are found in the book called Veda. In India, we have books called Vedas. Many people think that they are the original Vedas. But in those pages of those books, it is described that these are only copied from the original Veda. Those who have eyes to see and ears to hear, they are expected to listen something from this book and see something from this book and copy it down in their own pages, as many pages as they can. When we made so, these are the books that are resulted. Therefore, we call these books by the name Veda. That is what the Vedas say. Those who have no idea of these books, they think that Vedas means the written original written books. They believe the written books are the originals. Whereas the authors believe that the written books are not originals, but are copies. That is what one knows when he directly begins to read the Vedas. And to explain the Veda, there are the four Vedas. The Rig Veda, which explains us about the voice and utterance. And the Sama Veda, which explains about the song, which we call the respiration. And the Yajurveda, which explains about the plan of creation, which we call the mind. That is the space mind. A part of which is the mind of the solar system. A part of which is the mind of our planet. A part of which is the mind of every atom on this earth. And on the way to evolution, each atom reaches the human stage, when the little human brain also has a part of that mind. So this is something about the original book. And to make us know more and more about this book, the ancient seers have given some more literature. For example, the Puranas, which give in the form of a good allegory the whole story of the creation with all the details. And then the Darshanas. These are six schools of thought which give us the capacity to look at the same book from six angles of vision. And they are supplementary to each other. Unless we can supplement the knowledge of these six angles, we are not expected to know what is Veda or understand Veda, the book of creation. So let us try to take one by one and explain the content of each darshana in as much a non-technical way as possible. Remember, the word darshana means vision. Six darshanas means six angles of vision. First, I will give you the list of the six darshanas. The first one is called Sankhya. That means wisdom of numbers. The second is called yoga. We are very much familiar about this word. Therefore, we have as many misunderstandings about the meaning as we are people here. Because for the past 60 years in the Occident, every fellow is doing some nonsense and calling it yoga. But there are people who teach us what is really yoga. For example, the masters of wisdom. And here, yoga means the science which is contained in the Patanjali's yoga. It is called the Eightfold Path of Yoga Discipline. And the result of this is to see that the prisoner in the cage is made to understand that he is the lord of his constitution. So this is the only science which makes you a lord out of a prisoner. Without the aid of this science, we will be puppets in the hands of our emotions. Every moment getting disturbed and going into all types of astral influences like anger, confusion and hatred by the deeds of everyone around us. That means everyone can disturb you and play with you as if with a dog unless you know the science of life and the art of living. It is yoga. All of you know there are many subdivisions in it.